Now the campus sport review of the 27th Winter Universiade. The cross-country skiing and ski jumping were held at Štrbské Pleso in Slovakia. And for the first time in FISU history, there was a ski jumping team competition for women. Team Russia won it. They had Irina Avakumova, a highly ranked World Cup athlete, and already the winner of the individual competition here. I was able to win this competition due to the high quality of my training, and also my experience played a role. It's not the first time I've taken part in important competitions. The Russian delegation dominated the whole Winter Universiade, especially in cross-country. Altogether, they won 56 medals, 20 gold, 18 silver and 18 bronze. Partly because Russia has invested heavily in university sports.
Universiade, especially, is a very good chance for young athletes as a reserve for national team. Come here to demonstrate their potentials and to be in the future, present the country on the top level event like Olympic Games and World Championships.
With 7 gold medals of the 7 team medals in 9 cross-country competitions, Russian athletes were almost unbeatable. Andrei Larkov took 3 titles in the sprint, the mass start, and the relay. The defending champion in the Nordic combined was Adam Sisla from Poland, the physical education student from the University of Warsaw. He'd won 2 titles in Trentino. Now he doubted himself before these games, but once again he walked away with 2 golds and a lot of confidence in his future. I'm really happy to be World University champion for the 2nd time. I'm really satisfied that I could make it once again. The biathlon took place at Osrblie, and much was expected from the local star, Paulina Fialkova. She'd taken part in the Sochi Olympics. Fialkova's a student of Matej Bell University in Banska Bystrica, and she didn't disappoint the fans here. She got the gold in the 7.5-kilometer sprint, bronze in the 15-kilometer individual, and silver in the 10-kilometer pursuit. The 2nd part of the Winter Universiade was held in southern Spain, some 1,200 athletes from 41 nations taking part. On a difficult track in the Sierra Nevada mountains, the men's Super G was won by Michelangelo Tentori of Italy, just 1/100th of a second ahead of Mark Oliveras from Andorra. 6 days later, Tentori got another gold, this time in the giant slalom, beating his teammate Rocco Del Sante. The most successful female skier was the Norwegian Christina Fausa Osberg. With the victory in the Super G and the giant slalom, Christina was more than satisfied.
I did some great races back home in Norway before this, and I came here with a lot of confidence. I hope that I can make more great results and ski up to my potential.
Among the top figure skaters at the Games, Germany's Peter Liebers. He'd finished 8th at the Olympics in Sochi. Now at the Universiade Igloo in Granada, he overcame a shoulder injury and skated his Olympic program to become Universiade champion. In ice hockey, Russia and Canada battled for the women's gold with a final score 3-0, the Russians taking the title. Japan took the bronze, beating China 4-1. And the games ended with the men's ice hockey final, the Russian team defeating Kazakhstan 3-1. It was Russia's 6th Universiade triumph in a row. Altogether at the games, Russia dominated the medal table ahead of South Korea and Kazakhstan. For the first time, the Winter University Games have been held in 2 different countries, Slovakia and Spain, representing 540 universities. The next edition in 2017 will be held in the city of Almaty in Kazakhstan. Still to come, the university memories of the IOC president, a review of the Summer Universiade in Guangzhou, the Olympic biathlon champion, Mikko Grice, on his student experiences, and a look ahead to the action in 2016.
Today's stars. tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.